नमस्ते स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द टॉपिक राइबोसोम्स, कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ राइबोसोम्स। सो व्हाट आर द राइबोसोम्स? राइबोसोम्स आर द एंजाइम्स प्लस राइबोस न्यूक्लिक एसिड, द सिंपल टर्म। सो ए राइबोसोम इज एन आरएनए मॉलिक्यूल। राइबोस न्यूक्लिक एसिड मीन्स आरएनए, डीएनए and RNA, we know nucleic acids. So ribose nucleic acid, the RNA molecule that is capable of performing special biochemical reactions. It is a RNA molecule with enzyme. So what are the characteristic features of RNA molecules and enzyme that uses RNA? It is a substrate, it is an RNA with enzymatic activity, it is an enzyme that catalyzes the association between the large small ribosomal, and it is an enzyme that synthesizes RNA as a part of the transcription process. It is an enzyme that synthesizes RNA dimers during RNA replication. So these are the characteristics of the RNA molecules. And a ribosome should have some characteristic. What is the ribosome? Ribosome is an RNA molecule that is capable of performing some biological reactions, because it is now enzyme. And ribosome means ribonucleic acid enzyme. Ribosomes are RNA molecules which are endowed with the catalytic activity, and they have capability to perform like enzymes. They are like enzyme. They have capability to. These RNA molecules have capability to react like enzyme. They are catalyzing reactions, and they also contain sequence that perform cleavage reactions. What are the types of ribosomes? Group 1, group 2, intron splicing ribosome, RNase-free, hammerhead ribosomes, hairpin ribosomes, and ribosomes. The first one is group 1 intron splicing ribosomes. Group 1 intron ribosome constitute one of the main classes of ribosomes. They are found in the bacteria and lower eukaryotes. What is their mechanism? The group 1 splicing reaction require a guanine residues cofactor and a 3-OH group of guanosine. In the mechanism, the 3-OH group attacks the 5-OH phosphate group of intron, and a new phosphodiester bond is formed. The 3-OH of the exon that is displaced now acts as the nucleophile in a similar reaction. So in the exon 1 and intron 2 molecule, this group is cleaved and they are joined together. The group 2 intron splicing group and the group 2 intron have been found in bacteria. They are in the bacteria, and they are also found in the mitochondria and chloroplast. What is the mechanism of group 2 intron splicing? The 2-OH means there is a side to first group, second carbon, third carbon, fourth carbon, fifth carbon. So on the second OH group of the adenosine, specific adenosine, as is a nucleophile, it will act as a nucleophile and it will attack the 5-OH splicing site. This is the 5-OH splicing site of exon, and the 3-OH of the 5-OH exon attack the 3-OH splicing site, ligating the exon and releasing the intron. So it is the mainly used for the removal of introns from this process. Means introns are some non-coding regions. So this group 2 intron splicing will perform this function to remove this intron for the joining of exon 1 and exon 2. So for that, they are going to remove this 2-OH group from this side and from this side. They will cleave this region, and after cleaving this region, adduce 2-OH group and G5 region. They will cleave this region and they will join the exon 1 and exon 2 each other, and they will remove this region because it is a non-coding region and exons are coding regions, so they will remove this region. RNHP, what is that is the third type of RNA ribozymes, and RNA ribonucleosP, that is the RNHP is a ribonuclear protein, is an essential tRNA processing enzyme. It is found in all living organisms. And what is the mechanism of RNHP? RNHP enzymes are ribonuclear protein. In the ribonucleosP, protein component is facilitated binding between the RNA and tRNA substrate. So that is the RNA and tRNA substrate. This is the binding between the RNA and tRNA. This is the tRNA, and now RNA will bind to this region. It requires the divalent metal ion like Mg plus 2 for its activity. So using the RNA-D cut activity, they will add a CC group, and by this CC group, mature tRNA will be able to bind to another group. So in the RNA speed method, a mature tRNA have some spliced tRNA that do not have any excess regions. They do not have any excess regions. So it is used for the removal of some excess tRNA parts. Hammelhand ribozyme are tiny autoclitic RNA that cleave the single-stranded RNA. They are found in the nature as a part of certain virus-like elements. And the hammerhead ribozyme is so named because its secondary structure is similar to that of the hammerhead. The autocatalytic cleavage occurs via nucleophilic attack by the 2-hydroxyl of a specific core nucleotide on its adjacent phosphodiester domain, which produces a 2-3-cyclic phosphate, and it has some rolling circle method for the removal of the ribozymes. The next is hairpin ribozymes. In the hairpin ribozyme, it is an RNA motif that catalyzes RNA processing reaction essential for the replication of the satellite RNA molecules. And in contrast to the hammerhead ribozyme reactions, hairpin mediated cleavage and ligation process through a catalytic mechanism that does not require direct coordination of the metal cations. Spliceosomes is a large and complex molecule machine which is found in the nucleus of the eukaryotic cells, and the spliceosome removes introns from the transcribed pRNA. What are the applications of ribozymes? Ribozymes are capable of specially cleaving the RNA molecules. Ribozymes are used for the inhibition of gene expression. A phase 1 trial using the ribozyme gene therapy. So these all are about the ribozymes. You can ask me any questions in the comment box. Thank you very much.